Today we mourn the passing of an old friend. Though our friend passed many years ago now, we gather at this time of year to remember him. Our friend lived a long life, but died from heart failure at the brink of the new millennium. No one really knows how old he was, since his birth records were long ago lost in bureaucracy and red tape. He selflessly devoted his life to service in schools, hospitals, homes, factories, and offices, helping folks get jobs done without fanfare and without foolishness. For decades, petty rules, silly laws, and frivolous lawsuits held no power over our friend. He was credited with cultivating such valued lessons as to know when to come out of the rain, the early bird gets the worm, and life isn't always fair. Our dear friend lived by simple, sound financial policies. Don't spend more than you earn. Reliable parenting strategies such as the adults are in charge, not the kids. And it's okay to come in second. A veteran of the Industrial Revolution, the Great Depression, and the Technological Revolution, he survived cultural and educational trends including feminism, body piercing, whole language, and new math. But his health declined when he became infected with the "if it only helps one person, it's worth it" virus. In recent decades, his waning strength proved no match for the ravages of overbearing federal regulation. He watched in pain as good people became ruled by self-seeking lawyers and enlightened auditors. His health rapidly deteriorated when schools endlessly implemented zero-tolerance policies, when 6-year-old boys were charged with sexual harassment for kissing a classmate, when a teenager suspended for taking a swig of mouthwash after lunch, and when a teacher was fired for reprimanding an unruly student. His health declined even further when schools had to get parental consent to administer an aspirin to a student, but could not inform that same parent when a female student was pregnant or wanted an abortion. Finally, our dear friend lost his will to live as the Ten Commandments became contraband, churches became businesses, criminals received better treatment than the victims, and federal judges stuck their noses in everything from Boy Scouts to professional sports. As the end neared, our dear friend drifted in and out of logic, but was kept informed of developments regarding questionable regulations for asbestos, low-flow toilets, smart guns, and the neutering of prohibited laws and mandatory airbags. Finally, when told that the Homeowners Association restricted exterior furniture only to that which enhanced property values, he breathed his last. Our dear friend, known to most as Common Sense, was preceded in death by his parents, Truth and Trust, his wife, Discretion, his daughter, Responsibility, and his son, Reason. He is survived by 3 stepbrothers, Rights, Tolerance, and Wiener. Not many attended his funeral because so few realized he was gone. May Common Sense rest in peace.